How to program and use temporized start-stop with ATV Logic on ATV 320. Hello, today we will show you how to program and use temporized start-stop with ATV Logic on ATV 320. The goal is to showcase the ATV Logic function by developing a code example on ATV 320. The function will use the M00X memories, some function blocks like counter, read and write internal data, and operation modes of ATV 320. The function starts the drive by the DI1 logic input, run and forward input, and starts the motor at the reference speed set on analogic input AI1. The elapsed time is shown in the value monet delay t in my menu. The motor will stop after a temporization set here in set delay time. We'll show you how to configure these two parameters in the section Add Personalized Settings in My Menu. The other functions of the drive are set to default and may be adapted to the user's needs. Program with ATV Logic. You don't need to be connected to the drive to do the programming. In the ATV Logic tab, select the Post tab. ATV Logic provides three different tasks: pre, post, aux. Here is how to use the task. In pre-post tasks, connection to fast access parameters only, size limited and M00X limited. In the aux task, connection to slow and fast access parameters, HSP, LSP, ACC, DEC. The drive app described here is the main task of the drive to control the motor. This task is not manageable by the user. Configure a logic input of ATV logic task to a hardware logic input. Double-click on I1 icon and configure the virtual I1 to hardware digital input 1, DI1 with 24 VCC. Choose discrete in the list and digital input 1 in the right list, which displays all the features that can be assigned to I1. Validate with the OK button. DI1 will decrease the counter value from the preset value to 0. Configure a logic output of ATV logic task to a hardware logic output. Double-click on O1 icon and configure the virtual O1 to hardware FW. Choose discrete in the list and FRD, forward, in the right list, which displays all the features that can be assigned to O1. Validate with the OK button. O1 will be active until the counter reaches the value 0. Build the program. In the ATV Logic toolbar, choose the desired block and drag and drop it onto the frame. Connect the inputs and outputs to the blocks. Connect logic signals to logic inputs of the blocks, black links. The edge block avoids a disturbed signal on DI1. Connect the output of the edge block to the load input of the count block, fourth input. Connect analog or register outputs to the analog inputs of the blocks, green links. Double-click on the bit read block, B02, to program the ADL container address. For this block, we choose the bit 6 and the M003 address block parameter equals @14980. Set 14980 in the logical address. Double-click on the read block B05 to program the ADL container address. For this block, we choose the M002 address block parameter equals @14971. Set 14971 in the logical address. Double-click on the write block, B06, to program the ADL container address. For this block, we choose the M005 address block parameter equals @14974. Set 14974 in the logical address. Note, M001 to M004 are saved in EEPROM, but M005 to M008 are written in RAM. Double-click on the compare block B04 to configure the comparison function to IN1 greater than IN2. Double-click on the constant block B07 to set or verify the value of the constant to 0. Program explanation. In this example, the virtual logic input I1 of the ATV logic program is assigned to DI1, hardware digital logic input number 1 equals LI1. I1 signal is assigned to an edge front to avoid hazardous movement. The output of the front edge function is linked to a load input of a count function block. On DI1 activation, the count function block decreases the actual value from the preset value to 0. The count value is decreased by an internal system bit, bit 6. The read block is used to set the temporization setting value. The write block is used to control the actual value of the count block. Their values are defined in My Menu by the user. When DI1 is activated, the output of the count function block is set to 1 and drives the virtual output 01 assigned to FW order. Thus, the ATV320 starts. When the actual value reaches 0, the output of the count function block is set to 0 and stops the ATV320. Add personalized settings in My Menu. In So Move menu, select Device, then ATV320 HMI Personalization. Go into the My Menu tab. In the HMI Organization list, find M002 and M005 and add them to the right. Go into the Parameters tab and repeat the same actions. Add a customer unit to the parameters. M002 is the temporization setting value, set delay time in seconds. M005 is the actual temporization read value, monet delay t in seconds. This short label will be visible and understandable by a machine operator. The program is finished in local mode. Check the program and transfer it to the drive. Check the program to verify it conforms to the limitations. In the ATV Logic toolbar, click on the Checkmark button to check the program. Errors and warnings are displayed in the corresponding tabs, Error and Warning. Correct the errors if necessary. Validate with the OK button. Connect the drive to your computer using a communication cable. Transfer the program to the drive. Note that if ATV logic tasks are running, some transfer operations are not allowed, like downloading or uploading files. Go into the Parameters tab. The access level of the drive is basic. In My Menu tab, set the needed value for the temporization. Set delay time. The program task is managed by parameters to start and stop upon ATV320 power on. After downloading, to execute the program, you should set the function block activation FBCD parameter to start for testing. To be more efficient, we recommend the following parameters on operational modes of the ATV logic task: FBCD, FBRM, FBSM and FBDF parameters in the Function Blocks tab. Run the program. The program will be executed in connected mode with an ATV320 connected to SoMove. Start the program with the Run button on the ATV Logic toolbar. Update the animation with the Update button on the ATV Logic toolbar. The animation program is not updated in real time. The links are in red color if active. Operational mode. The FBCD, FBRM, FBSM and FBDF parameters in the Function Blocks tab, manage the running mode of the ATV logic tasks in parallel of the Drive Application task. The Drive Application task is running with DI1, hardware logic input, and the motor is running. The ATV logic tasks and their behaviors in case of errors are managed by these parameters. The ATV logic tasks may be running automatically at ATV 320 startup if Function Block Start Mode, FBRM, is set to Yes. If Function Block Start Mode, FBRM, is assigned to a logic input, DI1, DI2, it will execute or stop the ATV logic program. For more information, refer to the ATV Logic Manual. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.